Hello, happy Sunday. I got a request yesterday for a song. The version I was sent was sung by Laura Lynn, and it's a Kris Kristofferson song, Why Me? Happy Sunday, everybody. Last couple years now, a real long stretch of pretty severe debilitation from fibromyalgia. So when I was asked to sing this song, I just had to. It was about 3 years ago. I guess you'd say I turned to Jesus. And I grew up Catholic, and I grew up singing in the church. I went to a Catholic school all the way down the other end of the bay, took the bus. You know, we all did. And we're all faithful, and we're all this, that, and the other thing. And a few years ago, I just found that I couldn't get through this health crisis, right? And everything around me had fallen apart, right? I lost my career, my health, my mom passed away, my dad passed away, my unborn little angel baby Winston, my husband left. And a few years went by, and I had my family home built, and I had my little boys all squared away. But I had severe anxiety, and I had severe depression, and I still had the nerve pain from fibromyalgia, and literally every move I took was searingly painful, right? Nerve pain. And I even went in the mental. I did. The summer 2018, we call it the mental here in Newfoundland. It's the mental health facility. And I'd had the stomach flu that week, so my boys and I were over at my brother's and his wife, and you know, there's something wrong with Asetha when she ain't eating, but I couldn't eat. And poor old Lisa was like rubbing this cream all over me, like a prescription anti-inflammatory, I suppose, and nothing was working. And all I wanted was to be a mother, wonderful mother. I couldn't see that I was a wonderful mother. And so every thought in my head was that I was an awful mother, and it didn't matter what I did, that's how I felt. was an awful mother and was really, really hard to live with. So this summer, the boys weren't very old 3 years ago, so they were probably 2 and 4, right? And I ended up, like I said, with this, I ended up having panic attacks, and I had to be outside all the time with the boys in order to feel like I could breathe. I couldn't even wear socks. If I put socks on my feet, I felt restricted, right? This is how intense it was. And I was going along normal like this. I had my boys all day long in the daytimes, right? And many overnights. And anyways, thank God for my brother, who I actually hopped into bed with one day over to his house and was like, everything's going to leave me. Like, I'm just going to float away and everything's going to be gone. That's really how I felt. And they spoke to me and said, we think you should go out to the Waterford, right? And I was like, yes, boy, I think I should. I said, I would have went there before, but the bed's going to be hard as rocks. Like, how will I survive? I said, with fibro, like, every inch of me aches and hurts and there's sharp pain. And it's all bad enough. Like, I'm barely hanging in there. But I was at the point, there's nothing else to do but to go to Waterford to go check myself in. So I looked at my brother and I said, boy, will you get me a pizza? I'll go in if he gets me a pizza. So sure enough, I had me a pizza later on that day. And maybe I'll have to tell you more of the story another day. But I was in there 33 days. I was in the Waterford for about half of it, locked down in a unit. And I was out in the health sciences for the rest of it, in the bowels of the hospital. Right. I'm serious. The psychiatric unit is in the bowels. Like, if you weren't stressed out before you went in. Anyways, I'm going to get political here now, and I shouldn't, because the care is absolutely wonderful. I have never looked back. I was given all kinds of resources. And I feel like I should say, like, I know now that I'm out the other end. And I turned to Jesus and I just said, look, I'm at a loss. I don't know what more else I can do. And I think that was 2 years ago. I think it was a year after I came out of the mental health facility. And not a word of a lie, that day I started writing songs, and I hadn't written songs in over a decade. And as you well know, if you've watched me at all, I haven't stopped writing songs. They just flows like the river. So I really think turning to Jesus, and to be honest, the first reason I did it was because I felt like I couldn't believe a man would ever love me, right? And I'm still single. But anyways, that's besides the point. I was like, if I can't believe that Jesus loves me and Jesus loves everybody, how can I ever expect someone to truly love me? And if I can't expect someone to truly love me, then I'm not in for a very good ride in life, right? It's going to be difficult. It's going to be much like I've experienced to date. So I said, if I can get in touch with Jesus, right, and I can really feel the love of Jesus, I got a hope and a prayer. Because, see, I grew up, I was all about God. God was fine. It wasn't at first. I remember Mother teaching me to say my prayers, kneel down by the bed, right? And I started to cry, and I was beside myself, terrified to say my prayers. And she said, my Jesus, what's wrong with you, right? My Jesus, what's wrong? You're afraid of everything. I said, well, I don't want God to walk back to me. I don't want him to talk back to me. And of course, Mother's eyes glistened, right? Oh, she thinks back on that now. She tried to laugh at me. Anyway, she said, Jesus, God, haven't got time to talk back to you. Don't be so foolish. So I was all about God. But the Jesus, he was just too close. He was like a person, right? Jesus don't love me. I'm wretched. That's how I felt. Anyways, I did turn to Jesus. From writing songs ever since. And people ask me for these requests. It makes me feel like I'm on the path. You know? I walks with Jesus, I suppose they says. I don't know. It's like my nan had it up on her wall, that footprints poem. Why, when it was so difficult, was there only one set of footprints? Right? Why is there only one? Like, I could barely cope. I felt that. I could barely cope. And it's because he's holding you and carrying you, and it's the footprints of Jesus. So it's just kind of funny. I could say Jesus 25 times in a row, see now? Jesus, 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 Jesus. And it got nothing to do with religion. It got nothing to do with anything political. It truly is this, like, mega force of love that's been prayed to by billions of people for, like, centuries. Like, it's tapping into that and letting it clear out the cobwebs and clear out the crud, clear out your pipes. Because what's inside you just wants to flow. That's what I've learned. I was born a songwriter. And I'm not sure I got many skills beyond it, to tell you the truth. And all those years of sickness and everything and held me back from it. And I still got my limitations of fibromyalgia. But I can let that love flow right through me now. And write these songs and reach out to you guys in whatever way I can. And everything's blossoming. So anyways, I don't know where that's going to land in your heart, or it might land up your hole. I don't know. But boy, Jesus is a force of love. So I mean, I don't see any reason not to sing about Jesus. I've written a lot of songs. Today I just felt like this song, I really need this today and fill myself up. And I really need to put it out to you guys and need to connect with you guys, because I do feel like I'm in some sort of love bubble with like thousands of people. So anyways, aren't you glad I sang first? So you know, stop and then move on, not listen to all this. But I got to do what I'm called to do, right? I opened up to the love of Jesus, and by golly, I'm not going to stop now. I hope everybody's doing good, and you know, I'm not making light of mental health or anything. Trust me, I've walked that path, and I'm not saying that Jesus heals deep depressions or anxiety. I'm saying that I take the medication, I get the counseling, I take care of myself, and I love myself, and I do all those things, and I let the love of Jesus flow through me. I love you guys. Happy Halloween. Bye.